Okay, so we're going to talk about disc bulge and herniation, and are they the same thing? And if not, what makes them different? So let's get started here. So this is your back. This is me looking down at you. If I were to do an MRI, this is, you know, what we call the top-down view. And so these are the different components of a segment of your spine. Let's use L5-S1, for example. So L5-S1. And so when I'm looking at you from the top down, I'm going to see down here, this is your spinous process. That's the hard part when you press your back. And then off to the side here, you cannot feel those. Those are just more bony structures to help protect in the nerves, which you see here in red. And so in the center here is called your central canal, and that houses the spinal cord. And off to the side, we have what's called a nerve root, L5-S1, L4-L5. Those are different nerve roots, and they provide strength and sensation to the leg. That's going to be important to know in just a second. Here's the inside of the disc, and so this is the disc itself. Now, there are some natural variations in the size and the strength and the shape, but a lot of times they have a little bit more of this oval look to them. Excuse my drawing, I'm not perfect, but in the middle here, we have the nucleus pulposus, and that is mostly a water-based structure that kind of helps absorb some of that force when we bend over and we extend our back and we rotate. Quite amazing structures. They're really, really cool. And on the outside, we have called the annulus, so annulus, and that helps control that nucleus pulposus and keep it inside there. And it's dense collagen that happens to be a bunch of parallel fibers that runs through here that has a ton of strength and stability of that level, L5-S1 or L4-L5, just provides strength and stability, non-contractile, which means it's not muscle. It just flexes with us and extends with us so we can do really cool things and lift heavy things. Now, sometimes we can have a disc bulge, and what that means is that that disc or nucleus pulposus, D-I-S-K, D-I-S-C, I've seen it spelled both ways, depending on what part of the world you live, but you're gonna have a bulging of that nucleus pulposus. It's gonna head towards that nerve root, but it's not actually gonna extend through the annulus. And so it's not that big of a deal. You know why? Because 50% of people in their third and fourth decade of their life have disc bulges with no symptoms, and that number goes up and up and up as we get older, and it occurs at many levels. So what I tell my patients is it's just wrinkles on the inside. It's fairly normal, and while you may not want to have it, it does happen at many areas of your back. And more often than not, people have them. And so they can have disc bulges without symptoms, most commonly L5-S1, and it's just something that happens over time. Not the greatest news in the world, but also not awful because you don't have symptoms. Why do you care if you don't have symptoms? Now, when people start to have symptoms, it's more likely related when that disc gets a little bit closer to the nerve root, and that happens through a herniation. And so that disc will actually protrude a little bit through that annulus, and then it happens off to the side and typically only affects one side. It doesn't usually go in the middle or both sides. And so if it is L5-S1 on my left leg, I would maybe expect some calf tingling or the side and my leg tingling with maybe a little bit of weakness and pain. You may or may not have back pain with it, but with a herniation, you're more likely to have symptoms. But in that same study, they found that people often had herniations without any symptoms as well. So it needs to be correlated with your exam. If you're one of those people that they accidentally found a herniation when they were looking for other things, don't worry about it. It just means that you've been on this earth a few days. And so the main difference between the herniation and the bulge is how far that disc moves out of the annulus or towards the nerve root. And so everybody has a little bit of variety. Sometimes their discs are inherently a little bit weaker or a little bit stronger, but in general, most people don't even have symptoms with disc bulges, and with herniations, you may or may not have symptoms. But both of those things, the incidence of both of those increase over time. And so when I'm working with somebody and they ask me the question, are they the same thing? No, but they're fairly similar. They're within just a staging or progression, and then that they can get better over time. And that there was a really cool study that came out, and that if I do have a herniation, does that disc material ever go back? Is it ever gone? Or what happens to it when it comes out here? Well, I can tell you when it comes out here and you have symptoms, it's because your body's having an inflammatory response, and that it's sending a bunch of really cool things to that area to remove that pressure off the nerve. It helps you do that on your own. And that if I do an MRI on day one, I'm going to see a herniation. And if I do an MRI on day 365, I'm more likely than not to see that that herniation is gone. Now, you heard me say herniation, but I didn't say anything about symptoms or pain because those things are different. I've treated plenty of patients who have severe herniations with no pain and plenty of patients who've had mild herniations with a lot of discomfort. There is a lot of variability. That's what makes it one of the hardest things to treat. And that's why we don't have a cure-all intervention as well. So, if you're having a herniation and you're having symptoms, you may have tingling, burning, weakness, or just sensation changes in the leg with or without back pain. And the disc bulge, you can have more local back pain or may not have any nerve root symptoms. And so it just depends person to person. But really, when you combine what you're feeling with what the clinical exam shows, it gives us a good start on what we should be doing in that moment to help you feel better. So disc bulges and herniations, definitely not the same thing, but they both can be there with no symptoms and they both can get better over time. Hope that makes sense. It's not all doom and gloom. Don't let anybody tell you differently. This is what the evidence shows, and this is what I've seen after nearly a decade of treating people. So if you guys found that information useful, please leave a comment and just let me know what you thought. But as always, guys, stay healthy, keep moving, and take care of yourself.